Good morning and a warm welcome to Aberdeen. After a lovely night in the Crowne Plaza here at Aberdeen Airport, a chain of hotel that is usually way above my pay grade, I made my way to one of the unofficial spotting areas. You can check out my Instagram in the description for the photos. Whilst spotting, I noticed an Eastern Jetstream 41, which was still sporting the basic Flybe livery. Having concluded my short spotting adventure, I found myself under a covered walkway, which led almost entirely to the terminal entrance. I personally believe this is a must-have for most airports in Scotland, which can leave passengers fighting the elements most months of the year. It would be lovely to see other airports catch on. Having completed the 10-minute walk from the hotel area, I made my way inside the terminal. The storm Isha in full effect, a few flights had been cancelled, let's hope ours won't follow the same fate. As our check-in wouldn't open until 12:55, we decided to get a bite to eat, stopping off in the WH Smith's. There is a small restaurant called the Granite City if off-the-shelf sandwiches aren't your thing. Did you know that self-seal envelopes were first developed in Aberdeen? I certainly didn't. At 12:55, we got ourselves checked in and through security. I didn't manage to pull out my phone in time to record either of them. Not that you can film in security.
Do you know what this video has turned into? Following Matt around Aberdeen Airport.
Is that all you've been doing? Is that all your video is going to be?
Yeah, it's just following Matt around airports.
If you pay close attention here, you can see my brain functioning in real time as whilst walking towards the boots, I spot a window in the gate area with a fantastic view across the apron, where a KLM Embraer E2 had just begun its pushback. Shortly afterwards, the departure board displayed our gate, gate 2. Luckily enough, we didn't have to move very far. Another 15 minutes having passed, we were called for boarding, which went without a hitch.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Having joined up with the rest of the pack, I got a good look at our aircraft for today's flight, Gulf Sierra Alpha Juliet Golf, which has flown its entire 24-year career in the UK with British Regional, Flybe and British Midland, before joining up with Loganair in the summer of 2020 after BMI Regional's demise. After this point, I'm not so sure as to what happened, however the footage got cut up into some smaller videos, much to my amusement. With that disappointment out of the way, I took position in today's seat, 14F, which offers lovely window views from over the wing. Not long having sat down, we began our pushback, which is done a little differently here in Aberdeen.
We also recommend you wear your seatbelt at all times while speaking. The emergency exits are one door forward on the right-hand side, one door forward on the left-hand side, and two overwing exits, one on each side of the cabin. Low-level lighting will guide you to an exit. If oxygen is required, masks will appear for panels above. Pull a mask sharply down, away from the cliff, and place over your nose and mouth.
Let's have a look around the seat, starting with the tray table, which was a tad wonky, a little like the A318 of Tarom, if you remember that trip report I did in October of 2022. The table was of good size, but did not extend. It did have an indentation for a cup if needed. Leg room was more than okay, with at least 3 inches between my knee and the seat. Seat itself could do with some reupholstering, but was well padded and comfortable. It wasn't long before the ERJ145 had us up in the cruise, a steady 31,000 feet, and with that our complimentary service was started. On Loganair you're offered either a cup of tea, coffee or water, and either a shortbread round or Loganair's signature caramel wafer. After the service, I continued my investigation. The seat back pocket contained a safety card and a generic white sick bag. I'll let you make your own judgement on this, however you can't expect much in the way of clean with the frequency of their services.
Please note your seatbelts are securely fastened. Armrests are
With the descending announcement being played, it meant our flight with Loganair today was coming to an end. However, this landing would be special, because thanks to Airport Action, who I will link in the description letting me use his footage, you will get exclusive outside video of our arrival into Birmingham.
Thank you. See you later.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. See you later.
The baggage reclaim carousel, yes, one, at Birmingham in the domestic section was small. However, with just two flights as we walked by it, it was sufficient enough. So with the no entry displaying loud on the floor, this is where I'll end today's video on this very delightful flight on Loganair. Everything from the staff kindness to the complimentary service on such a short route was top notch. And from other videos I can see of the airline, this isn't a fluke. I hope to fly on their aircraft once again very soon.